And now, around the world and around the corner, it's the David Bowers Awards, bringing the best in indie music to millions of listeners worldwide with your host, The David Bowers. We've got a fantastic lineup of guests, as well as our engineer extraordinaire, Nick the Geek, our entire crew here at the Asylum, and me. I'm John Bon Jovial. And now, here's the voice of indie music, The David Bowers.
Thank you very much, the legendary John Bon Jovial, and welcome back once again for another hour of music, mirth, merriment, madness, and all those other M words. And we are with an exciting show today. We've got some big news coming up, and of course, talk with some indie artists and some great indie music. Like, for example, a girl who calls herself Agnes and has released a song called Good Life.
Oh,
There you go. Agnes Emilia Carlson, known mononymously as Agnes, a Swedish recording artist. She rose to fame as the winner of Idol 2005, the second season of the Swedish Idol series. Agnes has cited Stevie Wonder as her inspiration and has also mentioned Whitney Houston and Janet Jackson as musical inspirations as well. Agnes, check her out. You can find her all the usual places online. And that's her brand new release, Good Life. One word if you're Googling it, the word Good Life, all one word, and look for just plain old Agnes. What'd you think, John Bon Jovial?
Well, I like the song. I'm not a huge fan of disco, as you well know, but I was listening to this. She's got a nice melodic voice, and just thinking to myself, she reminds me of somebody. And you and I were talking about it on the intercom just now. And just as the song was ending, I flashed on it. It reminds me of Debbie Harry from Blondie doing Heart of Glass. And which was one of the few disco style songs that Blondie ever did. Pretty well done too, but she also, you mentioned Gloria Gaynor and I mentioned Donna Summer, and I think that if you could combine all three of them together, maybe this is the sound that we're talking about.
That would be an interesting combination. Why
yes,
didn't Giorgio Moroder think of that? I don't know. Can't put the knock on Giorgio. He did a fantastic job with the artists that he worked with. But
he did.
It's an interesting sound, and I think it's a very commercial sound. And we don't say disco anymore, by the way. It's dance music now.
Oh, dance music.
And,
yes.
And that makes it cool. Haven't you ever noticed? Disco, bad word. But you say dance music, and wow, yeah, everybody's up for it. So,
I remember listening to Rick Dees in L.A. many years ago. And, of course, back then, the type of language that you could use on the air was much tighter than it is today. There's all kinds of things.
I can't
even begin to imagine saying some of the things that are said today when you and I were on the air. However, the one thing that he did say, which I can remember very well, was that disco creates a vacuum.
Yes, I remember, and that has become a mantra for people who hate disco music.
yes, exactly, precisely.
Oh, how are things in John Bon Jovial land this week,
well,
John?
Well, we're just kind of hanging out and being hip here in the swamp. It has been absolutely gorgeous weather, and I would have to say probably the best winter that we've had in easily 10 years. The temperatures have not been too hot. We've had most days in the 70s and down into the 50s at night, although this week is supposed to warm up a bit. I would have to say that this particular winter, anybody that is experiencing Florida for the first time probably is going to fall in love.
In other words, you'll have a lot more tourists in the future.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Make a little bit more money, one hopes.
Hey, exactly. You complain about the overpopulation, the driving, and all those other things, and then go home and count the cash you made off of them.
Oh, well, absolutely, because we may curse the snowbirds from time to time, but bless their pointed little heads, they do pay my bills, and I appreciate it.
Absolutely. Okay, we have a very special announcement that we've been just dying to make, and we finally have the release that we can go ahead and talk about it, so we're going to do that right now. I'm honored to announce that I was invited to work on the advisory committee for the Native American Style Flute Awards, the world's first global awards program dedicated to all players, makers, and instructors of Native American style flute. Now, the new NASFA website is up and running now. That's NASFA, for Native American Style Flute Association, NASFA. So when we say NASFA, you'll know what we're talking about. The site is nasfahonors.com. Of course, they have all the information, the background, and what's going on in the world of Native American flutes, and some huge announcements, too. If you haven't yet and you follow flute music, then like NASFA. Follow them on Facebook at facebook.com /Native American Style Flute Awards. Check them out. NASFA, their motto is Our Breath, Hearts, and Flutes Join Together in Unity. The advisory committee, of which I am proud to be a part of, includes Jan Michael Looking Wolf, the director, Robin Gentlewolf, program coordinator, Sean Justice, filmmaker of Justice Pictures, Stevie and Chrissy Shepherd, One World Radio, Dana Reason, composer, musicologist, and recording artist, Tim Yett, producer, author, artist, Keith Summers, producer, composer, and performing artist, and little old me. And I am very honored to be a part of that and to bring the show into part of the Native American music world. And as part of our participation and consulting with the Native American Style Flute Awards, it's my great pleasure to announce the other part of our big announcement. The David Bowers Awards will be carrying the first annual NASFA nomination announcements. Now, this will be a special presentation of the David Bowers Awards. It will be available the weekend of February 28th and all the following week. So follow the David Bowers Awards on Blog Talk Radio, as well as our social media postings for more information. And this will be carried on all services that carry the David Bowers Award. And John Bon Jovial, we're proud to have you join us as part of the program for the Native American Style Flute Awards.
I'm thrilled. I'm just absolutely beside myself. This is a big deal. People just don't realize this is a huge deal because, you know, the Native American population in this country is so influential in not only mainstream so-called European white music, but just developing styles of their own that are just heart-rendering and grab at your soul. So for something like this to come along and to include us in it, I'm honored. I am highly honored by this.
As am I, and we're looking forward to the awards nomination program coming up later this month. Follow us, keep up on what's going on, and what's really amazing, and I have learned now having become a part of the program, as it were, it's not just North America. I mean, we are talking worldwide with some of the biggest names in flute music, in Native American flute music around the world. We're talking an audience literally of millions of people and some very, very big and well-known names. So it's not limited to just here in America or North America. It's worldwide. And I have just been blown away by the participation. Check them out on Facebook. The following, the posts that people are putting up, the music, the videos, the watch parties, it is really awesome. Check it out. I know you're going to want to be here for that show. And as I said, that will be on the weekend of February 28th and all through that following week. So watch for it. Native American Style Flute Awards right here on the David Bowers Awards, where every show is an award show. And we want to salute some of our people. We want to salute Mary Perry, first and foremost, accredited disability representative in Rochester, New York, who underwrites the David Bowers Awards on WRFZ, FM 106.3, Rochester Free Radio for the people of Rochester. And we thank her, and we love our audience there in Rochester, some great people. And while you're at it, if you're into oldies, don't forget to check out Jeff Moulton's ABC Oldies Saturday evenings at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. You can find it right here online as well. And check them out. As I said, this is a show where every show is an award show. We have mentioned our awards that we have coming up. John Bon Jovial, we've got about 1 minute here. Do you have an award for us this week?
Oh, a problem. Well, I don't know if you want to call it an award or not. Of course, as this show is being recorded for air in a few days, as we record this, last night was the 92nd Academy Awards show, and it was, you know, the hashtag had been circulating, what was it, Oscars So White, I think, and I really think
something like that, yeah.
I really think the hashtag should be just changed to Oscars So Bland.